ball, finds a hole up the middle.
Steps up, goes deep left side, receiver open, counting, touchdown Titans! Takes a dice shot outside the goal box, and he will break the 0-0 tie. Fantastic shot by Kenlof Solin.
Giller makes a move, a good one, opportunity here, the Bears score! The Bears strike first.
He's at the 40, he's down to the 30, the 20, 10,
5, touchdown, Jalen. Why not? What a beautiful run. Maureen there fights her off the puck. Opportunity here. Another sit. And a goal! Second chance effort for the Pioneers.
Put the icing on the cake, if you will, Michael. Let it go down and got to the outside and said good evening and good night.
It's Rivalry Saturday here at Tartan Arena as the Minnesota boys high school hockey season wraps up the final week of the regular season with a Metro East rivalry matchup here between the North Polars and the Tartan Titans. Alongside Sam Erickson, we are here live for TV19. Sam, how are we doing today?
Oh, I'm doing just fine, Alex. Should be a great matchup. Got two teams kind of battling out in the middle of the pack of the Metro East. But every game counts as we get ever closer to that postseason. There's the standings right there. You see Tartan in fourth place, North right behind them. North with a 500 record, pretty close to a 500 record overall, but Tartan at 7-4-1 in conference and a very nice 15-6-1 record overall. A couple high-scoring offenses here, so it should be some exciting hockey.
We'll go ahead and take a look at tonight's matchup. The second meeting of the year between these two clubs. As you can see there, Sam, North beat Tartan 5-2 at Polar Arena on the 22nd of December and won 8 of its first 11 games, but has lost 7 of its last 11.
Yeah, and then Alex, you see Tartan on the other side. They tied Hill Murray 3-3 on December 15th and beat Matamidi, a very good Matamidi team, 6-0 on January 19th a few weeks ago. They've won 7 of their last 8, and they've got 13 seniors on this team. So this experienced squad is definitely gaining some steam headed towards the postseason.
Well, we talk about experience and we talk about players to watch. Both have some great goal scorers. First, we got Corey Polarski, the sophomore for the North Polars. He scored 22 goals this year with 24 assists and has 6 power play goals for the young sophomore.
Yeah, and over on Tartan's side, you got Sam Lindahl. He's pretty similar in the numbers. You see 24 goals, 23 assists for 47 points. Both those players averaging over 2 points per game as they've played about 22 games. So very impressive numbers. As I mentioned, should be a high-scoring affair, an exciting game here this afternoon.
Well, we'll be right back for Puck Drop from Tartan Arena. Polars and the Titans coming up here on TV19.
You've messed up your son's haircut. Do you try to fix it? Work with what you've got? Or show solidarity?
Thank you, babe.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
Welcome back inside Tartan Arena. It's Rivalry Saturday as District 622 rivals, the Tartan Titans and North Polars, play here at Tartan Arena. Alongside Sam Erickson, I'm Alex Westhead. There we are. Hi, Mom.
Hi, everybody.
And we're here for what should be a wonderful matchup here in Section 4AA.
Yeah, it should be a great game. A couple high-scoring teams here in the Metro East. Real excited for this one. You know, kind of late season here in Minnesota. It's high school hockey. What's not to be excited about?
Exactly. We'll take a look at the starting goaltenders. We take a look at the North St. Paul side. That's number 35. That's Ben Herman getting the start for the Polars.
Yeah, Herman 4-4 on the year with a 3.24 goals against average, 8.95 save percentage. As I said, a couple more offensive teams, but that's a look at the North goalie, and there's the Tartan goalie there. That, I believe, is Bennett Pagansky. He kind of gets the lion's share of the work. Both these teams split up their goalkeeping work a lot, but that's Pagansky, number 30. He's 9-5-1 on the year with a 3.29 goals against average and an 8.93 save percentage.
Well, the puck has dropped, and we are underway here at Tartan Arena as the Polars try to enter the zone. Fall offside, a North skater falls down. That blue line will trip you up every time. And we'll get a faceoff back at neutral ice.
Yeah, I saw a couple skaters kind of lose their footing skating with the introduction. So a little slippery to start. Fresh sheet ice.
Faceoff one here by the Polars. He'll send it to the zone where Tartan can control. Taking it behind the net. That's Matt Solheid. Leaves it up ahead as it's pinned against the half wall. As there's Tabaka now taking it out, and the Polars can control at center ice. The dump and chase will begin. And it gets down into the corner along the half wall. Back behind the goal for 28. Comes into the circle as the Polars hold the zone. Cross ice pass doesn't quite go, and Tabaka will take it the other way for Tartan. He'll dump it into the zone, and some lines will change here early. Going to chase now. Here comes Kirby Larson, tried to leave the puck there, but it goes to the opposite side. As we get the ball, the puck now behind the goal line. Centering pass in front, misses wide. Tartan with some early pressure.
A good opportunity there for the Titans, just knocked wide on the attack though.
Into the zone as the Polars try and clear back out. Working through center though, but it holds here at net center ice.
And I'll be interested to see, Alex, we had kind of a couple players to watch. Both these teams kind of rely on a couple star players. Interested to see how much they play out there on the ice tonight. You got 15 Lindahl for Tartan, and kind of the combination of Pilarski, Rubish, and Conroy for North St. Paul. So we'll see how much time they're on the ice. Looks like that top line for North is not out there right now.
Here comes North St. Paul back the other way, as that's Ryan Stokes coming in, and we have a penalty being called, I believe.
Yeah, it looks like tripping call number 38 for Tartan is going to be heading to the box. That's Logan Roberts. That'll be 2 minutes then for this high-scoring North St. Paul team, that top line. This will be a good opportunity.
Well, Sam, we talked about it before the puck drop, where this North St. Paul team, that top line, had one of the highest-scoring lines in the state of Minnesota, but has since tailed off here. And it'll be interesting to see what happens as they get their first crack on the power play as they hold the puck in the offensive zone. There's Noah Smith, tries to leave it too far for the defenseman, Jake Edmonds, and it'll come back down the ice the other way to the goaltender, Ben Herman.
Yeah, we mentioned in our pregame that North beat Tartan the first time these two met, 5-2, and one of the things about that game is North got off to a 3-0 start in the first period. Something I'm sure they're going to want to do again here, get off to a quick start, and that penalty is going to help them.
North gaining control now, trying to take it back the other way. Pinned up against the wall, but gaining the zone. As the puck comes high into the air, back out through center, and they'll have to retouch for the offside. Coming back into the zone now, here's Kevin Pilarski. Kevin working off the half board, tries to dish it back, too far though, and the line change will come again for Tartan as they continue to kill on this power play. A minute left to go for the Polars. Puck comes back into the defensive zone for North St. Paul, as here's Kubiatowicz now leaving it up. As Tartan, they control again, sending into the zone, and a two-on-one breakaway shorthanded shot and a save by Herman as it comes back to the half wall and quickly back on the rush. If they hurry, they can have numbers. Shot on goal and a great save by Pagansky. Looked to go glove side. We'll get a face-off coming in the defensive zone.
Nice save here by Herman on the shorthanded opportunity for Tartan, closing off that angle, unable to control the rebound, but nice help by the Polar defense to clear it for him.
Face-off coming to the goaltender's left. It's won by Tartan. They'll look to clear it out, and they will. With 30 seconds going on this power play, Herman leaves it behind his net as the Polars try and set up the breakout. Up through neutral ice now. On the far side, that's Corey Pilarski. Pilarski into the zone. Tries a backhand shot and a save by the goaltender there as it comes back to the blue line, back in deep now.
There's a look at why Pilarski is such a lethal scorer, able to skate in kind of untouched on net there. Good stop, though, by Pagansky.
Little shovel pass in front, and it goes to the corner as the Tartan penalty kill comes up strong, and they're back to full strength. Another shot on goal as Pagansky reached the butterfly. But North St. Paul continues to apply pressure. Pinned down low below the boards as they'll try and come up through center.
Good pressure from the Polars. Too bad they didn't have that with the power play. Not able to get a whole lot of good shots on that power play.
Trying to maintain the puck. That was Joe Rubish. Rubish played football for North St. Paul back in the fall. We covered a couple of games for North St. Paul and
had a very good team a year ago. Made it to the state tournament. Lost a lot of seniors this year, though.
A nice strong hit on the boards as Sam Lindahl laid out the first major hit of the game. As the puck comes off a skate, hits the rafters at the top of the building, and we should get a faceoff coming at neutral ice.
Yeah, low-lying ceiling here at the Tartan Arena. And as soon as that makes any contact with those rafters above, we'll have a stoppage and a faceoff.
So we'll get that faceoff in neutral ice. North St. Paul wins. They'll keep it alive in their own defensive zone as they look to break it out through center. A little tip pass in negates the icing. And the Tartan will chase. Here up on the half wall, up into the bench. As North St. Paul is able to race back. Trying to fight for possession there as they hold it along the half wall. Comes back to the blue line. Shovel pass in front, an opportunity. And it just sails wide as Grant McDonald couldn't get a handle on it. Back to the blue line, shot off the defender. And here they come back through center ice. Here come the Polars, or they'll try to anyway, as they get it back now. Josh Korngable up ahead, and the Polars will chip it in. Tartan will chase now as that's Matt Solhide leaves it on the near side as they look to start the breakout. Here's Jacob Betts now taking the puck, fans on the pass, and he'll simply send it in as North will gain control once again. Shots early here, two on two, as another great hit there by, I believe that's Noah Smith laying out, and the physicality has ramped up early, Sam.
Yeah, so far, as expected, pretty even game. Low scoring, a little lower scoring than maybe we would have imagined, but a rivalry game always kind of so evenly matched that sometimes you can throw those numbers out the window.
Well, we'll get that icing touch up. We'll get a faceoff coming to the left of Ben Herman for North St. Paul. You know, we talked about it here in the open and the JV game. As we were setting up here for today, there was a little bit of a skirmish on the ice before the game. So definitely the rivalry still very strong here for both of these clubs.
Yeah, definitely a lot of players know each other on both sides of this rivalry. These two schools, as you mentioned, share a school district, very close in proximity to one another. So these kids know each other growing up playing hockey and maybe develop some rivalries at that age. And kind of nice to see them duel it out here at the high school level as well.
Tartan controlling in the offensive zone as we had a slip there, Charlie Tabaka. We've noticed in the opening period here, there's been a lot of slips, maybe a bit of ice condition problems here today at Tartan Arena. So it'll be interesting to see how that continues as play goes on.
Well, you know, we're getting a little later into the season, a little warmer weather out there in Minnesota right now. A lot of wear and tear on that ice, you know, from the whole season. So that may make a difference.
Shot from the corner, a nice save by Pagansky as it comes back out, and Tartan will try and set up an opportunity as just couldn't quite get it going, and the Polars will take control again. A great defensive stick there by Lindahl. Another great check there by Lindahl too to keep it alive.
Now you saw the strength there by Lindahl, and unable to keep his feet there in the corner. Got taken down, lost the puck.
Puck once again comes down into the Tartan defensive end. 9:45 here to go, opening period. Still no score. Shots favoring the visiting Polars here. 3-2 in the early going. Puck continues to go behind the defensive zone as
funny
goes back, and a nice save by Pagansky there as it comes to the half wall. Skating in now, as it looks like the Polars can control off the glass. And the icing call will come, and we'll get a face-off coming to the goaltender's right with 9:10 to go here in the opening period.
Yeah, kind of feeling each other out here in the early going, Alex. Not much to speak of. You know, we had that one penalty, not a whole lot for North offensively on that penalty. Got a couple shots, but not really able to set anything up. That's, I guess, why you see we got no score.
Very quickly on the breakaway, here's Kirby Larson, a shot and a save by Pagansky. He'll get the glove on it. And a great way to stop a two-on-one as what could have been a very strong offensive chance.
Yeah, nice pounce by Pagansky as that was kind of bouncing, took a weird deflection and actually was heading towards his net. I think it was going right on net. And nice reaction. Good cover by the defense. You saw a Tartan player go crashing into the boards there.
Tartan looking to get play going again. A turnover as the puck is held in the zone. A shot and a save by Pagansky. Taken down as the puck goes over the net. And a great play by Nick Bolin to keep that puck swatting it away from trickling into the net.
Boy, what a presence of mind there as that puck was up in the air. That may have gone into the back of the net. I don't know what exactly happened there. We'll have to take another look at that. But he batted that out of midair, kept it out of the goal. You saw Pagansky wasn't going to be able to get up to it. But stays out of net. We'll take a look here.
Wow, what an effort there.
And a couple Tartan players reacting to it. I think you're right. Who is that? Number 22, Nick Bolin, first to it. Getting it with the glove. Impressive play.
Into the zone come the Titans. As Lindahl will control. Working here now. Tries to leave it in lower. An opportunity here off of the blocker there, and a great save as the Polars look to break out the other way, but Tartan will hold the zone.
You know, Alex, I think it's real important whoever scores the first goal here tonight. It's going to be really important as things have gone scoreless so far. I think that's going to be even bigger now.
And we'll get a faceoff coming here. North St. Paul in their red uniforms. A big white N on the center with the North St. Paul High School crest on the shoulder. The Tartan Titans are wearing their home whites, the black stripes down the sides, the T with the lightning bolt in the center. Blue numbers, black trim here. Moving right to left as Lindahl moves a shot just wide of the net.
We said Lindahl, 47 points coming to this one. You saw the strength he has on the puck. Able to get a shot off there, I don't know, two, three guys on him. Impressive stuff from number 15 for Tartan.
Here's Justin Thompson now taking control for the Titans. Moving up now is that's Grant McDonald who keeps it alive, chasing the puck in low. McDonald applying some nice pressure there by Kevin Pilarski. As the puck stays alive in the defensive zone. As we get a little bit of a scrum in front and the puck gets shot wide, and I believe we have a delayed penalty call. We have a trip coming up here, Sam. And once again, the Polars, I believe, will go on the power play as Bobby Veitch will take a seat for 2 minutes.
And if you're Tartan, that's something you don't want to have happen. North already with one power play, wasn't able to capitalize, but don't give them too many more chances. They got that really prolific scoring top line with Rubish, Conroy, and of course Pilarski. And you're going to see those three out there.
Face off, one, an open net, score! You said it yourself, there he is, Corey Pilarski, bears his 23rd of the season on the power play, and the Polars take an early lead.
Beautiful backhand, Alex, I wish I would have made the call. I was going to say, I have a feeling North might score on this power play. 8 seconds is all it took, and that's a huge first goal for the Polars. They jumped out to a lead to beat Tartan last time, so looking good here.
Well, we'll take a look at the goal by Pilarski. That is a lot of open net and not anything that Bennett Pagansky can really do about that goal.
Yeah, I didn't quite see who got that first shot, but nice initial shot, forcing a tough save from Pagansky. Couldn't control the rebound. And Pilarski with a beautiful backhand.
23rd of the season for Pilarski, leads the team as Tartan will look to rebound from the early deficit.
I'll tell you something else about number 9, Corey Pilarski, the leading goal scorer for this North Polar team. Only a sophomore. So things are looking good in the future here for the Polars as well.
Polars control as they try and get back and add to their lead. Puck chipped along nicely, and Tartan may have numbers here as they hurry back off the post.
What a snipe. Whoa. Beautiful shot there by number 27, Joey Schaumer. That one clanked the iron. I think Ben Herman lucky to see that one deflect off and not go into the back of the net.
What a great chance of luck here, as we can see as they come into the zone, just rings it off the pipe. We could hear it here. I'm sure it heard the whole arena as well. Just a great opportunity goes by the wayside for Tartan.
We talked about these teams can score. I think that goal for North is really going to open things up, and I think we might have a lot of goals coming in the second and third period, if not more here in the first.
Puck controlled by Tartan in their own defensive zone. As the play comes up now, through center ice, up ahead for Lindahl. Lindahl has some help in Acker, as Lindahl knocked off the puck effectively. And it comes back to the half wall, too far, and if they hurry, the Polars can't have a break. Here they come now, as Trevin Stepan just sends it to the corner and goes to chase it behind the goal line.
Alex, nice job on the other end of the ice by number 19, Josh Korngiebel, to slow up Sam Lindahl. Lindahl was really determined to make a move. Korngiebel stood him up, and he almost led that, he led that breakaway going the other way, almost capitalized by the Polars.
A little bit of a scrum in the corner. Seems to be less concerned with the puck as the cross in front failed to reach a stick. Back to the blue line now. D to D pass. Sent in front, and the Polars control once again.
That's Tabak able to get right in front of net. Sorry, Alex.
Here's Rubish working it in, trying to keep it alive. But Tartan can control and clear back out. Gathered once again by Pilarski. As play seems to be more physical now, but Tartan will send it back in. Here they try to skate, a loose puck. Fought for their actor, a shot and a pad save. A great job to keep that one out, but Tartan will maintain pressure with 5 minutes to go here in this opening period. Fought for again in the corner. As they'll try and keep it alive. Some great defense though by the Polars as they try and clear out, but once again held in there. Graham McDonald fighting for the puck, falls down. Jabbing at the puck, will get a whistle. And I believe the puck was frozen, so we'll get a faceoff coming.
Yeah, good job by the Polars sustaining the pressure there from Tartan. Excellent job by North staying out of the penalty box so far here in the first period. As I think if North can get, it'll be really big for North if they can get to the first intermission with that 1-0 lead. I have a feeling they're going to face an onslaught though in the last four and a half.
Tartan trying to clear the zone, but they can't quite do so. As the puck comes to the corner, Matt Solheim turns it over. Little backhand shot save, Pagansky. And the puck goes into the corner once again.
I like that little nifty move by Stokes there. Just kind of backhand slid it on the ice.
Great play to keep it alive. Shot in the glove save as Joey Schammer, this time instead of the pipe, hits the glove. We'll get a faceoff coming.
Boy, that's a nice little shot though that he's got. Saw that one, as you mentioned, hit the pipe not too long ago, and then that one had a bit of mustard on it. Good glove by Herman in net.
Now we'll get a faceoff coming here to Herman's left. Shots on goal now, 6-6 aside. Only one has beaten the goaltender as Pilarski's 23rd of the season. And that's how we have the Polars with a 1-0 lead. As the puck carried behind the net, comes back to the blue line. Here it is, Reither, a shot, and it goes back out to the blue line where the Polars can try and clear and set up a breakout. Fought for, neutral ice, trying to move it along. And it looks like they can't quite do so, but they'll keep it alive. Here is Reither now, sends the puck in deep. And Herman will stop it behind his own net as two Polars collide, a wraparound score! What a mistake there by the Polars, and the Titans are able to even it up.
Yeah, it looked like it was Nick Bolin, number 22. Ended up getting that one. I glanced down for a second. All of a sudden, the puck's in the back of the net. Bad turnover in their own end by the Polars. And Tartan pounces, as I mentioned. It would have been huge for North to get into the break with that 1-0 lead. Just kind of a coming together, not good communication there by a couple defenders. And big goal for Tartan.
Well, just a terrible mistake. That's the seventh of the season for Nick Bolin. And with 3.5 to go, we are tied at one in the 6-2-2 rivalry here on TV19 Sports. As Tartan looks to add to their lead.
That's a shame, Alex, for North, as that's really an unforced error, kind of a careless goal, if you will.
And front score! The goaltender was down and he was out. And now Tartan, after two goals in about 20 seconds, takes a 2-1 lead.
And I believe that was Brad Herzog, number 11 for Tartan, getting that one. Not a whole lot Herman can do as Herzog was able to get right out in front of net. But excellent finish as Herman went low, Herzog hesitated, went high, and got it past him.
Third of the season in 18 games for Herzog, as Tartan now leads 2-1. is here they come once again, trying to keep pressure on, adding to this lead. Taken down and a penalty come, and the Titans should be on the power play.
Oh boy, this is quite the momentum swing, Alex, for Tartan. North kind of losing it a little bit here. You know, it all started with that first goal, just kind of gave it away, and then all of a sudden was, you know, a little slow to react after that first goal. Got scored on quick again, and now we got a penalty here. Getting a little sloppy on defense. Just a bit, you know, looking a little overwhelmed out there. Let's take a look. There's that second goal by Herzog, as you mentioned, only his third of the year, so.
Titans setting up on the power play, their first of the night. Polars 1-for-2 on theirs, as they'll win the puck back to the blue line. There's Reither now, sending a shot in front. And the puck stays alive as the Polars can clear, but a great defensive stick by Reither keeps it in.
Now Herman got lucky. He kind of vacated the crease a little bit there. I think if Tartan was able to get control of the puck, they might have sent it past him.
Down low to the corner for Acker, back to the blue line here. As he'll try and skate it out, Reither across. Back to the half wall, and Reither gets it again at the point. Reither, great hold there by Acker. Down and low for Lindahl. Lindahl keeping alive, and the pressure forces the puck out. As the Titans not doing a whole lot of shooting on the power play, mostly passing around.
Yeah, trying to set something up. Didn't get a shot off there. Good job by the Polars getting it all the way down to the other end, killing off some valuable seconds.
Here comes Tartan, trying to set the breakout, but a great stick lift there to keep the puck into the zone with the last 60 seconds on the man advantage for Tartan. As they look to keep it alive, Lindahl trying to make some physical plays as Lindahl gets a rebound, waits, and I believe the puck was covered up. And we'll get a little bit of pushing and shoving as we expected. Yeah, a great chance by the Tartan Titans.
I think Polar defender just trying to protect his goalie a little bit there as the whistle didn't sound right away. Excellent save by Herman as Sam Lindahl one-on-one with goalies. Not often he doesn't light the lamp in that case, so excellent by Herman to keep this one at 2-1.
Yeah, we talked about Lindahl in the open, 24 goals in the season. He was looking at a 25th right there.
We saw Pilarski score earlier. There's kind of another storyline going on here. That's what I'm looking for. Another storyline in this one is the individual scoring record here in the Metro East is Pilarski and Sam Lindahl kind of chasing each other. Lindahl with the 1 point advantage coming into this one, but with Pilarski's goal, they're both tied at 47. Yeah, don't you hate when you can't find that word?
Oh, as a broadcaster, it's the worst thing ever. As we're down to the last 10 on the Tartan power play, puck comes back out to center, and that should likely do it. A great stick there by Rubish as he tries to get the breakaway one-on-one. He can't quite get it, but he keeps the puck alive as Tartan controls in the last minute of this first period. And he might have one last rush.
You saw there why North can be so dangerous. If it gets in the hand of Conroy, Rubish, or Pilarski, they can make anything happen. So at any time, they're really, you know, able to score a goal out of nothing.
Here comes Tartan now, moving the puck in their own zone. Some great pressure. Try and force a mistake as the Polars chase into their own zone. A great back check by Acker as they try and set up one last rush to the Polars. As Lindahl makes a play all by himself, knocks over the goaltender, or he'll get knocked over himself, as Acker tries to play it in the corner. Acker working hard.
North needs to get it out of the zone here.
Back to the blue line, a tip in front, saved there by Herman. And we'll get a faceoff coming. Like you said, North really needs to get the puck out of the zone here, Sam.
That was an excellent save by Herman as that took a deflection. I think he even hopped once in front of him, and he was able to close up that five hole quick and make the stop. That was a tricky puck.
Just 8 ticks left on the clock here in the first period. As Lindahl lost the faceoff and the puck comes out through center, as Pagansky may have to make a save, but a great defensive stick. One last shot on goal, and that will do it here for the first period from Tartan Arena, with the Titans leading the Polars 2-1. And I think we'll come on back here for the start of the second period here from Tartan Arena on TV 19 Sports.
We've all seen stories of conflict that ended with peace. We've seen stories of hunger end in abundance. We see stories of fear, despair, and poverty, but they can end with courage, hope, and love with you. Be a part of writing a story that's greater than poverty. Learn how at worldvision.org.
Alvin and the Chipmunks want to remind you bacteria can hide in food and make you ill.
Wow.
But you can keep bacteria from ruining your day with four simple steps. Clean, separate, cook, and chill. The road trip to food safety starts at foodsafety.gov.
And welcome back here to Tartan Arena. As we come back for the start of the second period, Titans leading the Polars of North St. Paul 2-1 here in the second period. Alongside Sam Erickson, I'm Alex Wested, pleased to join you for this exciting Metro East Conference matchup.
Yeah, boy, things did get exciting towards the end of that first period. Take a look, that's the first goal North got on the board there. Corey Pilarski finishing off that, open that effort on the power play. Then a bit of a defensive miscue there by the Polars to make it 1-1, and then pretty much immediately following that one, Tartan able to catch the Polar defense napping there to make it 2-1. And North was a couple minutes away from getting into the break with a 1-0 lead, and things quickly changed. And now you see they're trailing. I think that would have been huge if they would could start the second period with that lead for North.
Well, it was just amazing how just a little bit of miscommunication behind the net, two guys knocking into each other, and all of a sudden, you're looking at a one-goal deficit as opposed to a one-goal lead, and that's just the game of hockey for you, how anything can change at a moment's notice. As we take a look here at some of the upcoming broadcasts for TV19, we'll be at White Bear Lake as they will play the Eastridge Raptors in girls basketball. And, of course, we'll have the rematches of the 6-22 battle between these Polars and Titans as we are wrapping up the winter sports season here on TV19 Sports.
Yeah, not to mention you saw there at the bottom of the graphic left section tournament coverage as well, as we're kind of getting that underway. Girls hockey, I believe, started this afternoon. Boys hockey not too far behind, and then we got basketball. So a lot of good stuff coming up here on TV19.
Yeah, if you're curious about the Big Five schools and their progress today, the Hillmary Pioneers played Irondale St. Anthony in the first game of the afternoon at Aldrich Arena as they beat the Knights of Irondale. I think it was 7-1, 8-1, somewhere in there.
Sure, a comfortable result for the Pioneers.
And then I believe North Tartan plays White Bear Lake in about just an hour.
That's
both
exciting.
At Aldrich Arena.
Yeah, Fab Five matchup right there. That North Tartan program only in their second year as a combination, but good team.
And North Tartan with the 6th seed and girls 4AA, and White Bear Lake with the 3 seed. And of course, should White Bear Lake or North Tartan reach the final next Friday night at Aldrich, we will have the call for you as we look to see who will make the trek to the X. Depending on the high seed as well, of course. And in come the Polars. And a nice little shot in there and a quick save by Pagansky as we stop talking about the girls and bring back the boys here for the start of this second period.
We saw it late in that first period, Tartan get those 2 goals, take the lead. I'm just glad that we started to get some goals, though. Things are going to start getting exciting, I'm pretty sure. You know, for the majority of that first period, it's kind of scoreless, both teams feeling each other out. As soon as that first goal went in for North, kind of opened things up, and I think we got a few more goals in store for us.
Here comes Tartan now as the puck comes back out, and Bobby Veitch will take the puck, and he loses the handle there as Brad Herzog with a goal. The game tying goal for the Tartans as they'll try and send it back up the other way. Here's Veitch again. Loses the battle there to Stokes. We will send it in deep and the Polars can chase. Back to the half wall now. Polars trying to keep the play alive as they send a breakout, but the Polars can control there as it goes back into the defensive zone. And Jacob Betts, the sophomore, can take control. A long lead pass up ahead for Veitch as he'll carry into the zone. Veitch, a shot on goal, steered aside by Herman. And the play will continue in the corner in the Tartan offensive zone. Back to the blue line now. Pass goes wide in front as he'll try and keep it alive. Here's Veitch now behind his own net. As Tartan and the Polars will battle for it. Coming back, here they are. Skating up now, the Bowlers. A shot goes wide there by Trevin Stepan. And Tartan can control once again. And Sam, it seems here in the second period, Tartan's had the puck for a large majority of the time.
Yeah, definitely. I thought it was good for North to survive that little period down on the other end. I'm going to see what they can do here. But nice job by Tartan intercepting the puck back.
Here come the Titans. Shot on goal goes wide as Bowlin has the go-ahead goal for this Tartan Hockey Club as the puck goes to the corner once again. Back to the blue line, though, in deep. Grabbed out of the air, and it comes back out. We should get an icing call here. And that's what we'll get. And the faceoff will come to the right of the North St. Paul goaltender. 14:03 to go here, second period. Shots on goal favor the Titans, 12-8.
And you saw that top line out of the game for North St. Paul there. Good job by that second line coming in, kind of surviving things. And just giving those kids a breather. We'll see what these big scorers for North St. Paul can do, kind of with their first or secondary chance, I should say, here in the second period.
Centering pass, dangerous attempt in front. As here's Sam Lindahl now, the captain, trying to keep play alive. He'll send it up, chipped up over somebody, and here comes Acker now, moving into the zone. Knocked off the puck and down behind the goal line. Completely taken out as Kevin Pilarski will take control. Shot on goal, gloved out of the air by Ben Herman, and we'll get a stoppage in play.
Yeah, I think that one would have gone high, but nice job by Herman to glove it out in net as that sailed. That got through and made a way past a couple bodies.
And the faceoff will come here to the right of Herman. It'll be, that should be Lindahl on the draw for Tartan. And the faceoff one back to the blue line. As Lindahl now will keep it in low, pushing it there. Lindahl leaving it for Acker, but taking control of by the North St. Paul Bowlers. Down and low for Jack Smith. Tries to leave the puck up ahead, and a turnover. Keep play alive for Tartan. Acker in front, just missed the handle. A golden opportunity in front of the net, and Acker just couldn't get the stick on that shot.
Yeah, I think that was Lindahl that sent it over. Had to get some loft on it, but just a little bit too much. Acker looked like he had to basically bat it out in midair, unable to do so. Acker, good player, though, one of the top scorers for this Tartan team as well. In fact, the second leading scorer on 29 points. We'll take a look there. Yeah, it kind of short hopped actually right in front of him. That's a very tricky play. A nice pass by Lindahl. I think that was kind of the only move he had, was to get a little bit of loft on it. Found its way through.
Face off one in front, and I believe the puck may have skittered just wide as the North St. Paul goaltender Herman was down and out, but no puck reaching the back of the net. Play can continue now as the Polish trying to keep alive, but a great check forces them off the puck, and Bobby Veitch will keep it alive. Centering pass in front, and back to the goal goes wide. Here come the Polars again. A great pinch down low as the battle for that puck continues. And here's Veitch once more. Veitch, a backhander shot on goal. Sails wide. And comes back to the blue line and back down in low.
You can kind of see why North's had some difficulties this season. The depth an issue when that top line's not out. A lot of pressure on these other lines for the Polars. They're facing a lot of pressure from Tartan here, and it seems like kind of those secondary lines, Tartan's winning those battles. Well, nice job, though, by North there to keep Tartan off the score sheet and keep it at 2-1.
It's been impressive how North St. Paul has responded after giving up those two goals in that quick succession. I believe it was about 30 seconds to end the first period, and they have responded well and seem to be carrying some momentum as the shot goes high off to the pads. I believe that touched the goaltender and into the mesh above the boards. And the faceoff will stay in the offensive zone.
As you and I talked about it in between periods, this very easily could be 1-0 to North. Kind of a similar feel to start out the second period as we had in the first period. Tartan with a little more dominance, I would say, to start the second period, but kind of a nobody getting great looks in on net. Both teams sort of sharing possession.
Oh, we'll have a breakaway here almost, but a great defensive stick there by Luke Solheim, the sophomore, to stop that breakaway from happening altogether. As the puck comes back out through center, they'll say a tip, so the icing will be waved off. An opportunity and a bouncing puck high in the air.
That was a big opportunity off the turnover. Nice stop by Herman.
Here come the Polars again. Polarski, the one goal for North St. Paul, just missed over the glove. And the puck comes back out through to center.
Boy, I don't think that was too far off there by Polarski. He has got one heck of a shot.
Polarski moving in. Off of the defender, and it goes back into the corner. Here's Tartan now trying to move the puck back the other way. Too far for Bolin, and the Polars can control. That's Kevin Polarski. Turns it over. Bolin, centering pass in front, moving around. Can't quite get it. Maybe waited too long off of a skate. And Herman's able to come out, put the glove on it, and we'll get a whistle.
Yeah, good look by Dalton Reither. Tried to look like he was setting up to take a big slap shot, dropped it down low. Teammate just not expecting it, kind of hit off his skate and fell to Herman there, who was able to freeze the puck.
We'll get the face off here. As a puck battle won by Tartan, as he'll send it down low behind the goal line. And it comes back all the way out through to center. Icing is waved off as North St. Paul is able to beat that out. I'm not sure that the icing rule was applied accurately there, but nevertheless, play continues.
That could be big for North. So they're going to get some time in the Tartan zone here.
You can hear some of the family members here getting upset. I'm surprised there's no whistle there. There was a play right in front. And I believe the Tartan defender took him out of the play completely as a shot on goal. Misses wide, a nice juicy rebound. And the puck comes back out to the blue line.
Good spell here for the Polars. Yeah, a couple times maybe could have had some penalties. There's a hold, kind of right on front of the net. Yeah. Number 16 for North. Edmonds looking good, kind of breaking out. Almost got the puck there, nearly had a breakaway. Tartan able to knock that effort down, though.
Some great back and forth action both ways as Tartan and the Polars are going both ways. And here we go, a face-off to the right of the goaltender as a puck comes back to the blue line. Battle for it, centers in front, and the puck comes back to the blue line. Wristed shot goes wide, and the play can continue. Another shot off the post, and it looks like it'll be held in there. The Polars will come back the other way now, going to the corner. As here they come, now down behind the goal line low. And the battle for the puck will continue. Back to the blue line now. Chipped in low once again. And the Polars will look to control back up the other way. As here's Reither now moving the puck ahead. Down and low as North St. Paul takes control.
You know, it's interesting. The top line for North hasn't played a ton here in the second period. I wonder if that's a bit of a strategery by the North bench to kind of conserve energy for that third and final period. You know, hope that you can keep it at a one goal game as we have had a huge crash going into the net. I don't think there's any penalties call as the net just comes off the crease. I think we'll just have a face off for that.
You know, Sam, it's been interesting. We've been talking about the physical play and how it's been ramped up progressively here over the course of the second period here, but I'm surprised that it's been clean so far. There's been no real egregious plays, and I think the biggest hit was behind the goal that gave Tartan their first goal of the game. As play continues here, a shot and a great coverage there as it looked like Herman might have been a little bit out of position, but play can continue in the defensive zone.
Puck well,
centered
a
in
tricky
front.
Bounce. Yeah, wow.
And that was...
You gotta wonder if Herman kicked that goal off the crease there. As that one was bouncing right back towards him. It'd be interesting to take a look at that one. Sorry, Alex. But yeah, North survives nonetheless. You said it is getting physical out there, but everything's been clean. That's kind of the important thing, I think, out there. You know, we've had maybe some suspect penalties, but that was more holding, kind of some interference stuff. Nothing, like you said, egregious in any way. It's a friendly rivalry.
A friendly rivalry indeed. A long story one, as the Polars and the Titans have both continued for a long time here in Section 4AA. As the play can continue now, Tartan taking control, trying to move the puck up ahead. And here they come. A long lead pass too far. And again, we talked about the ice conditions early as players were falling all over the place, and it seems to have been again there.
Yeah, I think it might have something to do with the conditions outside as well as these heaters they got in here. I mean, I know it's going to be cold out over the center of the ice, but just it's probably a little bit warmer than normal inside the arena. You see a shot just go wide there. Not sure if Pogonski got anything to that one.
A chance for Kevin Pilarski, and he wrists it high and wide. Comes back to the blue line. And Tartan looks to begin a rush as they have a long lead pass, and here he comes once again. Moving the break hand, a penalty will be called. Shot follow-up, score! A delayed penalty called. North St. Paul doesn't like it.
I think the goal might have been off the crease there, though, before that one crossed over. As you see, it looks a little ajar. Boy, a frantic play there. As you mentioned, there was going to be a penalty call. That one ended up getting put in the net. But you see the North players at center ice kind of protesting with the officials that I think, and Herman and Nett is kind of pointing back towards the goal. We'll take a look here. As you see, the Tartan player, it's completely off.
You're right, that net is completely off.
You can look at it right now. It's tough. It's going to be tough for the officials to call it because, you can make a case that it happened after the goal went across. But as we see on our replay, that one should not count. That'll be a huge call going the Titans' way.
I'll take another look at it in here again. And he had him faked, did Herman, on the shot. But then it looks like he does lodge that net off as Jacob Betts was following up on the rebound. So this one should not count realistically.
And I'm not sure. I don't know if it came before that our replay there. I'm not sure what that penalty call was also. As at least on our shot, not a whole lot that the North defender did on the breakaway by, I believe that was Bolin for Tartan, number 22. We'll take a look here. Yeah, now we'll pick it up. This will be a good look. Yeah, there's a hook there. I saw that. Sorry, a replay before there didn't really show that. A little bit of contact, but that's a penalty you're going to want to take if you're North. I think the thing is you're going to have to stop that scoring opportunity. This is going to be a long discussion. The officials might turn this over. They're talking at the Tartan bench right now. And now a penalty. Sam Lindahl's going to the penalty box. I'm not sure what that's about because he wasn't the one on the breakaway. I thought there might be an interference call. You saw the player crash into the goalie, but looked like he got the puck off his stick.
Well, we'll wait for some sort of explanation from the PA announcement here. Of course, we have the replays. We know what should be called, but they don't on this side of the ice. We might have a penalty shot coming, I believe, as we take another look.
No, that's what they're signaling. I thought they were signaling maybe for the faceoff.
At least my belief is that there should be a penalty shot here because the opportunity.
I think that is what they're setting up for. But the interesting thing is why Sam Lindahl's over in the penalty box.
He may have said something. There should be some. I believe there should be somebody in the North St. Paul box too, simply because
there was that call before everything happened. That was the first thing that happened.
Granted, it would be a penalty shot, so there'd be no reason for the penalty. But I'm curious, why is Sam Lindahl sitting in the penalty box? He had to have said something. We haven't seen a sign from either referee.
Yeah, the only thing I saw on the replay, too, was Lindahl just kind of coming over to congratulate the player after the goal. Can't really tell where Lindahl is. I think he might be on the far side of your screen, skating towards the middle. Behind the play there, you see him skating in. We're going to resume action. That goal did stand.
The goal stood. I don't know how, don't know why, but the goal did stand, and it is 3-1 Tartan as Sam Lindahl will take a seat in the box. And that'll set up North St. Paul on the power play. 1-for-2 thus far in the game. And we'll have to look for some sort of explanation because, Sam, I'm at a total loss.
Yeah, it's difficult if you're a polar there. That one shouldn't have counted. That goal had been coming off the crease quite a bit. And with all the contact that kind of happened out in front of net, I think the officials were kind of just having to pay attention to something else. But as you mentioned, I think before everything, it should have been a penalty shot or a penalty. Yeah, and I don't know how they just didn't see it. You saw the official skate in there at the end pointing that the goal was good. And
that is not an acceptable thing to do. I'm surprised you're not sending a penalty on that guy because he just took him and cross-checked him in the helmet.
After the faceoff or before the faceoff?
Before the faceoff even started.
So the friendly rivalry turning a little testy here. as you know, Tartan, as we've seen, credited with a goal that probably shouldn't have stood. What a shot there by North St. Paul.
Well, an interesting play so far as Tartan looking to beat out a puck. 3-on-1 now. As the Polars will break out again with a minute left to go on their third power play of this game. Moving into the zone now. He'll cut it back.
Yeah, their one goal coming on the power play. Corey Pilarski not out there right now.
Back to the blue line where they will control. Down and low. And then back to the circle. Trying to set her up for somebody in front. And if the pass would have reached, Kevin Pilarski had an empty net to shoot at.
Boy, good vision on that pass. And good execution as well as it got through.
And the play comes, knocked off the puck, staying alive, and it comes back out, or maybe not, as Tartan's able to control the puck once again. With 5:46 left to go in the second period, Tartan somehow, some way, leading 3-1 now, and they'll have a 2-on-2 chance here, but a great defensive play negated that pass.
Nice job keeping it in the zone. Good effort. Bolin, number 22, he's had a good game. Sam got that goal in the first period. He was the one who was on the breakaway on that goal that we just saw. Drew the penalty.
Well, here comes Lindahl out of the box. Lindahl working in. Tried to stick handle just a little bit, maybe too much. And the puck comes back to the half wall. Lindahl way out in front.
No, what a job. Did you see Herman
here? What a great save by Herman. You said it, Sam.
He jumped into it. He's like taking a bullet.
Herman without a stick as the play continues in the corner. Just a 3-on-1 now for the Polars as here they come. Pilarski in front. Oh, and just missed the tip there as Conroy just missed on it.
You know, Alex, I don't think Pilarski should have given up that shot. I think he could have got it off. I like the unselfish play, but he had a good look kind of right out in front.
Here come the Polars now, trying off high the glass, and the play's offside, just barely. As they just tried to toe the line on that one, and it just did not work.
This one's getting exciting, Alex. Things are kind of picking up here. Unfortunate that the goal stood. This one really would be tense at a one-goal game. But you know what? I have a feeling North is going to get one back here before too long. Face-off now as North is going to control it. And eventually Tartan will tap it into the zone.
And it looks like we'll have the play continue along the half wall. Sending it down and low as Veitch is able to control there for Tartan. Trying to look to add to this lead. Shots on goal now favor the Titans 22-8 as they have had most of the dominating play here in the second period.
Yeah, I just noticed that a moment ago, Alex. It does kind of feel that way. Tartan dominating, I would say, here in the second period, although only getting the one goal advantage.
Nice little opportunity in front. I believe that hit the net, too. I'm surprised no whistle came there as Tartan's able to start the breakout 3-on-2 through center ice. As here they come, McDonald, a wristed shot on goal, and a save by Herman there as it comes back across. Here they come now, skating up through neutral ice. And they can't quite clear it out. And here comes the goal scorer, Bolin, looking to get another. And right into the chest, that big N on the jersey. And we'll get a faceoff coming in the defensive zone.
Yeah, nice save from Herman. Bolin, as I mentioned, having a good game. But that one's pretty easy for the goalie there on North. But I think a smart decision just to kind of test him. Maybe try and get a rebound out there for the Titans.
Faceoff one off of the defender. And the puck will come to the half wall. And back into the blue line, down and low. Play trying to continue as they'll look to keep it alive. Now skating in, a shot and a nice save by Herman. And we'll get a faceoff coming. 3:08 to go here, second period. Titans leading 3-1.
That was Schammer, number 27. He had a couple in the first period. He's got one heck of a powerful shot, as we've seen. Probably the hardest hit puck that we've had today. Nice save again by Herman.
Oh, a great hit there too. As the puck comes back into the Tartan defensive zone, high off the boards. As Polars look to keep pressure alive and try and rebound in this one. We mentioned in the first matchup of the season, it was the Polars who came out to an early lead as Tartan enters the zone. Centering pass in front, just missed. Oh, they had Herman down and out, but they could not put it away. This play continues now in the offensive zone, down behind the goal line. This play will continue now, as here is Noah Smith trying to take control.
Risky pass there, just out of the reach.
We'll get the offside touch up. A faceoff coming here. Definitely a more exciting feel to the second period here, Sam. And entertaining hockey to be sure, is for all we know, these teams could be a first round matchup come section playoff time.
Yeah, for sure. That's a good point, Alex. As I saw, one section poll had them, I think, as 5 and 6, but very easily could end up at 4 and 5, ended up facing each other in that big quarterfinal Saturday in a couple weeks.
Yeah, we talk about that quarterfinal Saturday. That's February the 24th at Aldrich Arena. All 9 teams in section 4AA, including 4 of our Big 5 schools. Of course, the Matamidi Zephyrs will be in Class A, as they have been all season. And another threat for a state championship for the Zephyrs as well.
Yeah, definitely get the advantage of playing those big schools in the regular season and in conference. And I'm sure that pays off for the Zephyr program come postseason time.
Centering pass in front, comes back out to the far circle as they'll look to keep it alive in front for Lindahl, who lost a stick. A penalty will come, and the North St. Paul Polars will get their 4th chance on the power play, down 2.
And I was just going to say, I know I've kind of mentioned this a few times, but this game will get real exciting if North is able to net a goal in the last minute 39 here in the second period. That third period would really kick off and be exciting. It's going to be nonetheless, but if North's able to net one here, it should be fun to watch. And I think they got a good chance to do it.
Faceoff coming to the left of Pagansky. And it's won by the Titans, but it's held in at the blue line. A wristed shot coming high and into the mesh. Now we'll get another faceoff coming.
As I mentioned, that top line so dangerous for the Polars that they can score out of anything, or out of nowhere, I should say. And that top line's going to be out there, I would imagine, probably for the rest of this period.
Faceoff won by Tartan. It comes back to the blue line. And a nice defensive stick there to force it back to center. The Polars 1 for 3 on the power play. They scored first. And then Tartan scored the next 3 unanswered to lead 3-1 in the dying minutes here of this second period. Behind the goal line now, 2-1. Polars fighting over the Titans for this puck. And I'm sure the Titans are looking content to just run this clock out on this period and get to the dressing room.
Yeah, good trap on the board behind the goal. Nice effort from out wide.
Puck goes down and low, and they will skate out through center. That puck, there should be no icing here, as Herman played it to the corner. And the faceoff will come there as they'll keep trying to push it alive, get one last rush on the power play, but a turnover. Waiting patiently with it. As Tartan tries to set up, keeping play alive. Can't quite do so, and the puck will come down low. They'll carry it down low behind the boards. As we'll come into the corner to the last 20 of the second period. One last rush.
Good shorthanded hustle by Tartan there.
Corey Pilarski making some moves. Waits for his teammates to get onside. 13 moving in, and he's taken out of the play. Surprising lack of control there down to the last 5 of the period. As we'll count it down here, and that will look likely to end up the period, as a little bit of physicality after is expected, but nevertheless a good period for Tartan here in the second.
Yeah, great job by Tartan to limit that power play to end that period. There will be a man advantage for North for about 21 seconds as we start the third period with Tartan leading 3-1.
Well, we will be back for the start of the third period from Tartan Arena as the Titans head to the dressing room, 3-1 lead over the North St. Paul Polars right here on TV19 Sports.
To need me. You're going to need us. All of us. You're going to need our technical skills. our math, our engineering skills. You're going to need our help with your water, your air, your food. You're going to need our organizational skills, our problem-solving skills. You're going to need our determination, our honesty, our compassion. You're going to need the next generation of leaders to face the challenges the future will bring. And we promise we'll be there when you need us.
Drownings are a leading cause of death for young children. Simple safety steps are the best way to prevent these tragedies. Make sure kids learn how to swim. Always watch them in and around water. Properly fence all pools and stay away from drains. Consider the steps you take, then add a few more, because you never know which pool safety step will save a life until it does. Simple steps save lives. To learn some new ones, visit poolsafely.gov.
Welcome back, everybody. Sam Erickson here flying solo for our third period. My partner Alex Westad had to race on over to the Madness Sports Complex to call a little bit of announcing for the girls sectional tournament. So it'll be just me here with you for the third period. And if you're just joining us, well, that won't make much of a difference because all you'll be hearing is me. It was senior day here at Tartan. There's a look at some of the seniors as it's kind of reached that time of the year. Here in the winter sports season, see a lot of that as the teams honoring the families that have contributed so much to these players being a part of these varsity programs and contributing to these varsity programs. So nice festivities here at Tartan Arena this afternoon. And Tartan with a nice 3-1 lead going into this third and final period, hoping to pick up that W against rivals North St. Paul here this Saturday afternoon and in the late regular season. It's a Metro East Conference matchup. Both of these teams kind of sitting right by each other in conference. North behind Tartan. Tartan at 7-4-1. North 6-6-0. But North did get past Tartan in the first meeting between these two on the air, 5-2. But it's 3-1 here. North with a man advantage to start this third period. 10 seconds remaining on that. Puck right out in front of net. And it's frozen and fallen on by Bennett Pogonski. And we got a little something going on after the play. As we mentioned, this is a rivalry. These two share a school district. And for the most part, a friendly rivalry, but these players know each other pretty well. So anytime you're competing with people you know, sometimes things get a little testy. But nothing too bad there. And we're ready to continue action. As Tartan is back to full strength, so North St. Paul 1-for-4 on the power play tonight. Their lone goal coming by Corey Pilarski in the first period. That one stopped by Herman. Nice glove save. Didn't glove it as it's still live. And sent across ice off the boards. Kept in by Sam Lindahl. He'll drop it down to Thompson. That one shot in from distance and stopped by Herman. We'll have a face-off to the left of the goalie for North St. Paul. Both these teams share the same section for postseason play, section 4-2A. Some might have them listed as the 4 and 5 teams in this section. Of course, Tartan with the 4 seed, North with the 5 seed. That would mean that they would meet in the first round of the postseason. I saw a listing with them as 5 and 6, which would split up their matchup. But that 4-2A section kind of muddled up in the middle there. So this one would be big in terms of seeding, especially with North getting the win over Tartan earlier in the year. If they're able to pull off the win again here tonight, that might lock them up for that 5th spot. I don't know if they would leapfrog them over Tartan, even though they got the 2 wins. But it might put them right there at number 5 and could see a rematch with these two again. North threatening there. Puck carried into the zone. Good job by the Tartan defense. stopping that attack, and they'll take it the other way. Puck now into the corner, tapped up along the boards, and again, Logan Roberts with it. He's hip-checked, and Corey Pilarski takes on the turnover. Great pass to Joe Rubish, and Rubish, not sure if the goalie saved it or if it hit off the near side iron, but close effort denied, and it stays 3-1. Centering pass, that one hit wide, as I don't know if Herman would have had it covered in net for North St. Paul. We got end-to-end action here to start the third period in Oakdale. Centering again right out in front. Can't find it at his feet. And sent out of the zone by the Polars. Nice move inside. Shot on net. And stopped by Pagansky. With the shoulder, he'll freeze it up. And we'll have a faceoff. Take a look here at a replay. This is a shot, excellent pass there by Pilarski, drew the defense. You can see why that sophomore is regarded as one of the top players here in the Metro. Excellent presence of mind. As we mentioned, he's the leading goal scorer with 22 goals, 23 now after the goalie netted in this one, but also 24 assists for Pilarski. So kind of do it all. Just under 14 to go here, 3-1, Tartan leading. North St. Paul on the attack. They'll give it up. The puck trickles back to Ryther. Ryther passes it ahead and dumped into the zone. Chased down by Sam Lindahl. Lindahl skates out from behind the net. Still skating. Gives it off to Ryther. Ryther from distance. And that's gloved by Herman. Tartan out shooting North here, 28-11. And probably deservedly leading. North did get that power play goal, but haven't been terribly threatening on their other chances with the advantage. That goal coming 8 seconds into the power play. Tried to send it up along the board, stays in the zone. Thompson with it now down into the corner. He'll send it back out, flipped again, and poked out of the zone by the Polars. Tartan will have to reset. Try to be played up off the boards, but taken away by North, knocked down, and kept in the zone. That one shot too far away from a Polar player behind the net. And Tartan will take it away. McDonald with it on the near side boards, takes a hip check. And attempted to be flipped towards the center of the ice. Got away. Tartan will just dump it back into the zone and switch things up. Good chance here for the Polars. They carry it in onside. Shot. That hit a leg out in front. Tap back. Pilarski trying to just send it in front. Nobody there for the Polars. Good idea by number 9. Nice move. Shot in, and a glove save by Ben Herman. He's made a couple beauties here this evening. And that one's right up there with the best, as somehow it stays 3-1. Herman stopping the point-blank range opportunity. That was number 27 for Tartan, skating in on net. We'll take a look. Joey Schammer, he's got kind of the strongest shot as we've seen for Tartan. Denied right there, as you saw. We're going to have another face-off after it found the glove of Herman. Herman wants a stoppage. And I think his pad just came loose. .1202 now left to go. 3-1 your score. Tartan, the advantage of a controversial goal in the second period as the goal came off the crease. The whistle didn't sound. Tartan put it into the net after that. No way for the officials to review it here, and the goal stood. That's what makes it 3-1. North took the lead 1-0 off the Pilarski power play goal. Tartan responded quickly after kind of a defensive lapse. A couple of players for North collided in their own zone, leading to a turnover and a goal. And then shortly right thereafter, Tartan got their second goal, as kind of caught the North defense sleeping after they conceded the first. Pilarski skates back, picks his head up, bounces it off the boards, and sends it back down into the Tartan zone. No turnover here, Pilarski on net. That one shot right in, but right into the breadbasket of Pagansky for Tartan. Pagansky, 11:26 left to go in this final period. And a stop and start hockey here for the last few minutes. Tartan controls the faceoff. Lindahl with it, finds it at his feet. One of the co-leaders in scoring here in the Metro East Conference at 47 points. Pilarski got his 47th with a goal this afternoon. Skating in, nothing doing. Bumped off the puck. Tartan scrambling to get it out of the zone. They will. Now Lindahl with a two-on-one break. Lindahl doesn't pass it. Goes for the wrist shot. That goes high and over the net. And North will race the other direction. Herzog with it behind. He'll pass it up ahead. Try for the cross-ice pass. No good. But Tartan able to get it back. That takes a deflection and hits off the rafters, and we'll have a face-off. And let's see where they are going to do it, right to the left of Herman in the polar net. Face-off taken by Tartan. Thompson plays it behind. Kept in the zone by Herzog. Herzog tried to do something with it. Almost got it caught up. McDonald backhand. That's deflected. And eventually poked away and taken by the Polars. Still in the Tartan zone. Pilarski skating around. Another chance. Pilarski right on front. Fans on it. And that could have made it a 3-2 game if he would have made a connection. Pilarski skating with it on his backhand, and a stop. As I think the goal came off the crease, the referee spot that one. And we'll start it up again. Excellent opportunity as Pilarski just fanning on the backhand effort. We saw just missed there. Pagansky, I don't think really saw or knew about him on that weak side. You saw him looking around, I think asking questions of his defense. But no harm done. Noah Smith crashing in on net. Denied by a couple Tartan defenders. Smith has it now behind. And it's tapped away around the boards, kept in. Good spell here for the Polars. And the puck squirts away, however. Schaumer unable to get anything off. Excuse me, that wasn't Schaumer. That was number 22, Nick Bolin. Bolin able to get on the score sheet today. I believe he had the first to tie it up at one. And Bolin takes it again. He fans on it, stays with North. Played back behind. And attempt to send out, takes a funny deflection and right out in front. And nothing doing as Ryan Stokes missed that one. Nearly a good luck bounce by the Polars. Nothing came from it. And North will get another chance. Smith coming in. Smith with the wrister. Low save Pagansky, no call. Nobody knows where the puck is. And that's because Bennett Pagansky was sitting right on top of it. Clock will stop and we'll have a faceoff. Good save by Pagansky. He is up to 14 on the afternoon. On the other side, Herman with 25 saves for the Polars. Lindahl tries to tap it ahead. Kept in the zone. Long wrister right out in front. Herman able to slap it away with his stick. Good reaction from number 35 in net. 8 minutes now left to go. You hear the North fans encouraging the Polars to get it up ice and get back into this one. Good crowd on hand here at Tartan Ice Arena. A lot of friendships on both sides here. North winning the first matchup between these two, 5-2. Polars led 3-0 after the first period. Tartan climbed back into it to make it 3-2, but eventually the Polars got away, making it 5-2, and ended up winning it with that scoreline. Tartan reversing things here so far with a 3-1 lead. Thompson's going to chase after it. He's got somebody up in front. Deflected out of midair. It's hit. And that was just wide of net. And that could have got steered on the inside post. That would have been a goal. Great effort by number 40 for Tartan. That's Bobby Veach. And excellent two-line pass. Tap there on side. What a job getting a stick to it and keeping it live. Jake Edmonds, number 16, kept that play alive. Now the puck sails up and over the glass, out of play. Take a look. Here's a look at Veach. As you see, what a job to knock it down. And I just don't think he was able to get the angle on it to direct it on target. And Herman thankful to see it go wide. Couple sticks all over the ice, or maybe one broken in half. It's kicked to the side as Tartan races up into the north zone. Titan loses his footing, and North will take it. Mishandled by Edmonds. He gets it back and just clears it. That one goes wide. Six minutes now left to go. 3-1 lead for Tartan as they're trying to kill this one off. They would improve to 8-4-1 in Metro East play. North loses here. They drop below 500 in conference. Hard hit on the near side boards. Logan Roberts laying some wood. He's a little worse for the wear. He's going to skate over to the bench as Tartan changes things up. Stays in the polar zone. Sam Lindahl behind the net. Has it poked off him by Noah Smith. Lindahl makes a move. Smith still with him. Lindahl, though, hard to get off the puck. He'll leave it. Takes a deflection. And falls wide. Lindahl picks it back up. Skates out of the corner. Centering pass. Deflects off some skates. And goes wide again. Tartan really putting on the pressure here, trying to put this one to bed with the 3-1 lead. Another goal would pretty much do it. Lindahl, not sure what that hit, but it rattled around. And I think we're going to have a penalty. It's going to be against the Polars, though, as Tartan's going to be able to keep the pressure on. He's knocked out of midair. No call for the penalty, as I think a Polar player got something to it. And eventually they'll touch it. We'll have the whistle, but we'll also have a penalty. As it looks like North's going to go into the penalty box for the first time tonight. I think it's holding on Noah Smith, number 15. You see the replay there. .444 left to go in the game. That penalty is going to hurt North's chance of getting back into it. Starting has the skater advantage. This is the first power play for Tartan so far. But a shorthanded opportunity as Pilarski was able to get it up ahead. Conroy was chased down And nothing doing for the Polars as Tartan will reset their power play. Good job by Pilarski being active. Down in the Tartan end. Conroy tries to clear, kept in. It's gonna be a shot from outside. Not a whole lot of direction on it. That one will be cleared. Clears everything, doesn't leave the ice. And both teams will switch things up as we've got a minute left to go in the power play. Ibaka drops it back for Lindahl. Lindahl was looking up for a pass, finally finds one. Dalton Reither, low shot, rebound, and a goal. Number 44, C.J. Acker, one of the top scorers for this Tartan team, puts a stamp on things as the rebounded effort goes in to make it 4-1. And the power play goal just about seals it. Good shot. An initial save from Herman. The rebound spills to Acker, however, and he converts the opportunity. C.J. Acker coming into this one with 11 goals. That'll be number 12. And he's second on the team with 30 points now on the season. So just over three to go. And see if North can pull one back quick here and maybe pull a goalie and do something. But Lindahl's going to get an opportunity. That one goes high and wide. I think Herman got something to it. Lindahl still fighting. Everybody's still fighting. And eventually North ends up with a puck but can't clear the zone. Herman has to make a stop with no stick. Freezes the puck. And we'll have a faceoff. There's the initial save by Herman. And good job getting that pad back on that right side. Moving that right leg to close off that near side gap as Lindahl was pouncing on it, even with a few Polar defenders all around him. Herman hops, makes the glove save. And holds the puck. So Tartan scoring in every period here today. Got two in the first, one in the second, one here in the third. Out shooting North 32-15. Thompson plays off the board out. Another long shot. Huge deflection, and it's going to roll past Herman. Nothing he could do about that one. And I'm not sure who they're going to credit it to. But Jake Betts gets the goal. Oh, I think they're going to be waving it off. They are waving it off. It's going to stay 4-1. Not exactly sure what the call was there. Maybe a skate booted it into the net as it took a real big deflection. You see the shot from Betts going high. That's what got Herman to stand up. And I think it must have just been directed by a skate. And that's why the referees waved it off. Maybe a break there for North St. Paul. Although Tartan got a break on a goal in the second period. That made it a 3-1 game. I think North would rather have that call, because that really was a momentum killer. The goal came off the crease, and seconds later, Tartan put it into net. And the referees let it stand, because they didn't see it happen in live action. You could tell after the play that the goal was off the crease, obviously, but you know, to the referee's credit, they couldn't really tell when it happened if they didn't catch it in live time. 2 minutes now left to go. 4-1 the lead for Tartan. Delayed penalty call. And another hold. I think Thompson for Tartan's going to go to the penalty box. This will be a chance to see if North can pull one back in the late stages of this one. Minute 51 to go. Here's a look at the Tartan bench. Tartan coaches Steve Romanchuk. And with that power play, North pulled their goalies. So they're going to go with the 6-on-4 advantage, try and do something, get one back. Check, that one sent the other way, gets passed. A Polar not chased after by Tartan as he'll switch it up. Minute 20 to go. Carried into the zone. Kept in the zone. Tapped out in front. Right on the doorstep. And couldn't be turned in by Edmonds as he had a wide open net, but just couldn't steer it on target. Pilarski wrist shot. Boy, that was headed towards one of the corners, but excellently gloved by Pagansky. A lot of action here at the end of this one. Edmonds just missing out in front. Norris had a couple of those. And with that, I think we'll have a timeout here on the ice. The final 57.9 seconds left to go. There's a look at the empty net. Of course, empty now because both teams talking things over, but North has pulled their goalie. And we'll finish this one out with the 6-4 advantage. Gonna have some highlights from this game. And don't forget, you can always catch those highlights on SportsPath, one of the great programs we have here on Location TV 19. And we do that live every other Wednesday at 7 p.m. We got highlights, of course, of all the games we cover. Some post-game interviews as well as in-studio interviews, trivia questions, and a lot more. We highlight some athletes of the week. We talk your statistics and your standings and all that good stuff. Just keep you up to date with all of our Fab Five schools out here in the East Metro. We got a couple of them on display here this afternoon's action with Tartan and North St. Paul, so we'll for sure have those highlights on our next episode of Sports Path, which I believe is coming up on the 22nd of February. Had a couple of the North St. Paul guys in earlier on the season when they were up there in the scoring leaders. Pilarski, Joe Rubish, Nathan Conroy were nice enough to join us in studio. Talk to us a little bit about what it's like to play for this North St. Paul program. Wish those guys the best of luck the rest of the way. Shot well blocked by Tartan. Looked like McDonald lost his stick. Sent all the way down. 22 seconds and counting now. It's collected again by the Polars. Polars with the 6-on-4 advantage with the pulled goalie and penalty. That one towards the middle. Misses some sticks, hits some bodies, and Tartan clears, takes a deflection, and will go just wide of the net. Tartan's going to be first to it. Nothing doing there. And the buzzer will sound. Tartan's going to win this one, as it was an intense Metro East matchup, but the District 622 rivalry will go to Tartan, but these teams will split the season series. Tartan scores twice in the first, once in the second, once in the third to take it 4-1. Well, for everyone here at TV 19 Sports, we want to thank you for watching, and we will catch you next time.